I don't trust you.
I don't need you to trust me, but you will respect me. I'm not some cockroach that you can step on with a boot. Je suis le soleil, la lune. If you help me to find my body, I will be in your debt. Where I come from, debt is something that must be honored.
Welcome back, guys. So when it comes to Legion and going forward, I'm not going to be doing my usual style of reviews because what works for Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. doesn't really work for Legion. Instead, what I'm going to be doing over here is I'm going to be discussing those moments on the episode that I kind of find vital for the future of the season. So while I might at times break down an episode into its basic components, I will always focus those bigger picture moments, the kind of moments that drive me to conclusions by the end of any given episode. But this was another good episode. This was a really good episode, actually. Possibly one of the simpler, more straightforward ones as well. Even though, for Legion, straightforward is just like 10 levels of crazy higher than any other TV series, and only like 2 to 5 levels below the show's usual. But nonetheless, and without further ado, let's go. So number 1, there is this continuous conflict within David. Okay, so we see him on the first scene, and he's promising the Shadow King to help him get back his body, but nonetheless, nobody gets hurt. Then there is this other scene where he meets the Shadow King in the wheat field, and he tells him, no more killing. So pretty much David is setting this condition repeatedly in order to help the Shadow King find his body. And there is also that other issue that he does not really fully trust that version of Cid, future Cid. This does even get more obvious when he has this conversation with present day Cid at the end of the episode, telling her all about future Cid and what she told him and how he should be helping the Shadow King find his body. But establishing that this hesitation does exist brings us to number 2. So what I'm about to say over here is a matter of a theory wrapped within a question. And the question is, did we see two Davids or two versions of David on episode 2? Now please bear with me, because what I'm about to say is gonna sound a little bit crazy at first. So pretty much and throughout this episode, we do see David with two different hairstyles. The first one is the David with the messy hair, and the second one is David with the well-combed hair. And the question here is this one of David's abilities? So pretty much we do know that David could switch to any other personality that he absorbs in the comics, Legion that is. We do know as well that some of these personalities at some times were dispersed by David, and we know that at other times, those kind of personalities just escaped David, and he kind of had to catch up with them. So the question here is David switching or dispersing personalities in order to kind of convince himself to help the Shadow King? Because at his basic level, he's not convinced all the way through. You could even think of that situation with Carrie and Carrie as metaphorical towards what's going on with David. So we've got Carrie, he's absorbed into Carrie, with his arm hanging out of her chest. And pretty much we've got David possibly drowning in that other personality, a personality that he kind of switched to or let out in order to allow him to help the Shadow King. Because at some level, there is a struggle within the guy. I mean, he believes in Cid, future Cid, present Cid, doesn't really matter, it's Cid. Yet he does believe that helping the Shadow King is most probably a very bad idea. But number 3, let's talk the people with the chattering teeth. So I'm thinking their infection is either caused by 1, the plague that ends up consuming everyone or almost everyone in the future that Cid, future Cid that is kind of warning against. Or 2, they have been infected by the Shadow King, like they're this massive brain network that he's kind of using in order to find his body. That could as well explain how he figured out he could find the monk amidst the chattering teeth people on level 3. Obviously, that is the first place that Oliver goes for after having dealt with resistance as he enters the Admiral's base. Obviously, as well, we do see Amal Farouk's shadow as Oliver enters the third level, or level 3, with all the chattering teeth people. But number 4, so Clark is shaping up to be the antagonist once again. I mean, he's gonna be an antagonist, but not the antagonist. But nonetheless, thanks to Max on Discord, this is his prediction, and I do agree with him, like totally agree with him. So pretty much what Max expects over here is that Clark is gonna be some sort of an antagonist, just like he was on the first season, but in the very same manner that he was on season 1, he is going to end up by the end of the season, erring on the side of right, erring on the side of good. But moving on to number 5, all of those John Hamm narrations, I think they are pieces of a bigger puzzle that's gonna keep forming over the course of the entire season. So instead of other things hidden in plain sight like David's shirts on season 1, John Hamm's messages are gonna be the way of delivering all these subliminal messages throughout season 2. And this week's message starts with, "Reality is that which, when you stop believing in it, doesn't go away." So on last week's episode, and I think we really need to take record of these, he was discussing delusion, which can be linked to the concept of reality, because delusion has you perceiving reality in a different manner than the usual, just like the case is with the man with the leg, or the butterfly and Zhuang Zi, and how you perceive eggs as one and the same. Now speaking of perception, he discusses the tick and the bloodhound as perfect examples, but then he moves to the example of humans, that child being taught the colors wrong. Red is green, and green is red. Now as the little child repeats the colors, pointing to the wrong color on the board, the screen jumps to the egg that cracked into that black gooey insect. But red is green, and green is red. That develops into red means stop, and green means go. And the kid dies crossing the street because his perception of red is green and his perception of green is red, in the same manner that the perception of both eggs to be one and the same led to the birth of that gooey insect and the death of the chick, torn apart by it. Now just in case you think this message is all about David's perceptions, it's about the perception of all of us. So on season 1 they did one hell of a job making us doubt David's memories, but on season 2 they're doing a different job. They're pretty much making us doubt everyone and everything. Is Cid, future Cid, saying the truth? Is she even future Cid? Is she working for the Shadow King? Is she not working for the Shadow King? Should David help the Shadow King? Should he not help the Shadow King? Is the Shadow King the major villain of the season? Is the Admiral the major villain of the season? Or is it someone completely different? Is the Shadow King really a man of his word? Is he gonna help David defeat that other villain? And are those people with the chattering teeth a product of that thing that becomes a plague later on? Or are they the product of being used by the Shadow King? Or could they possibly be made that way by the Admiral in order to hide the monk? But finally though, number 6. There were two Easter eggs on this episode. The first one is all about the Shi'ar, mentioned by Carrie early on as he tried to work on that orb. Now this is in reference to the alien race with the same name who are associated a lot with the X-Men in the comics. But the other Easter egg, that came in the form of the story that Melanie relays to David about Oliver wanting to build a house for people like him. People with abilities. Now that reminds us all of Professor X and his school for mutants. But as I did mention earlier, I did think this episode was really good. I do not think the Shadow King is the villain of season 2 of Legion. I do think he's gonna be set up to be the villain of season 3. I do think that what future Cid is telling David holds true, or at least partially holds true. I've also got a feeling that the Admiral, the man with this weird basket on his head, is going to end up being the villain of the season. But that being said, let me know in the comments what you thought of the second episode of Legion Season 2. Let me know as well if you've got any theories as to how this season is going to play out. Now as per the usual, if you did like the content of this video, let me know by dropping it a much appreciated like. And if that were to be the case, it is also much appreciated if you subscribe and enable notifications for my future videos. Until I see you next time though, thank you all for tuning in, and have a great day.